this is the first paper that is they have made some simulation about realistic answer computation, and they propose that this is a scalable universal quantum computing. And scalable means that you can do quantum computing with many items. So this becomes very important. And after that, this paper shortly, there are many labs that are starting doing to do on-chip quantum computing. So this is the start of on-chip computing. And so before this paper, experimentalists already have good technology on tracking single ions, and actually spectroscopy of single ions and fundamental precision measurement of single electron have won Nobel Prize. And so the great things about that this system is that in ion traps, spontaneous emission is quenched. Okay, so anyway, the spontaneous decay rate is low. So if you have a qubit, you might say that the state of a qubit is in superposition of ground state and excited state. So if there is unwanted spontaneous emission, it will give some kind of error, and we normally call it decoherence. And this will cause information loss, and this is not reversible. So in quantum computing, we don't lack spontaneous emission. Okay. So we already know that in other systems that spontaneous emission are bad. So that in ion trap space, we'll like to use two states with the parity are selected very good, so that it is dipole transition forbidden. Okay. There are no dipole transition moment. They have only quadruple and higher order transition moment. And quadruple induced spontaneous emission rate is very low. So an atom, an ion, can be staying on a higher excited state for like a few seconds, and which is way longer than they propose that they think the daytime will be like milliseconds. So if everything works well, you can perform thousands of gates. Okay. So they first proposed that they have a linear four trap. Okay, so four trap, it is they have four electrodes. Okay, by giving AC voltage, they will cause a potential in X and Y direction. Okay, and then they put ions in the linear four trap. Okay. So what they are in mind is that
is that linear what?
Hole trap.
Hole trap.
Yeah, hole trap. Hole trap. Okay, so it is like ma mian. It causes ma spinning ma mian potential.
So they have three lines of that's a current going through or what?
They are voltage going, these two will have like higher voltage, and these two will have like low voltage. And for a short time, they will exchange. So the ions will feel like they will push to the y direction, and after a short time, they will push to the x direction.
So where is y and x?
And this is z. Z, they are ions along the z direction. Right, so they are like marbles. Okay, very easy. And what they want to do in quantum computation is they would like to have a universal quantum computation. The idea is that you have many qubits, okay? So you start with many qubit states, maybe some state like this, and many superposition of many states. And you engineer a gate or some Hamiltonian and let it evolve for some time, and it will have an effective unitary operator that is acting on the state, and then we have read out on the state. And we designed our Hamiltonian very carefully so that we can solve specific questions. So what I'm going to say is, if you want to build any kind of unitary operator, they have already known that you already need universal single qubit gate, that is quantum gate of a single ion, and some called C naught two qubit gate. Okay, and C naught Q two qubit gate is that if the first ion is on first qubit is on zero state, it doesn't affect on the second ion. Okay.
So you say this.
Each ion is a cube. Okay.
And it has how many degrees of freedom? It's only up and down.
Physically, it has many, but we will need three states in every atom to perform universal quantum computing. But the only states that are using that is used to pair information are two states. Okay, I will mention that later.
Here's a question: is it better for the ion to have large spins, or is it?
Oh, if you have, or you mean like heavy atoms?
Yeah.
For heavy atoms, the transition dipole moment will be high, so it is bad. Yeah. So, but if it is too, the mass is too small, okay, then some small perturbation will cause the ion to fly away. And we don't like that. So it will be something like, well, some paper they will use like HG ion or magnesium ion, something like that. And okay, back to C naught gate. Okay, so if the first qubit is in zero state, it doesn't do anything on the second qubit. By the first qubit is in one state, then the second qubit will perform a NOT gate. Okay, so one becomes zero and zero becomes one. Okay, we have like many qubits in this system. If we can perform arbitrary two qubits to this gate, and we can do arbitrary single qubit universal gates, then we can build any kind of quantum computation in principle. Okay, so you can see the most important thing is that we need a physical implementation of C naught gate across arbitrary two qubits. Okay, and this is hard. Only ion trap can do that. Not in cavity QED, not in solid state squid, no, they cannot do that. Only ion trap can do that. And this is still the biggest advantage of ion trap. That is the meaning of scalable. Because if you can only do a specific gates across specific qubits, when you are doing many quantum computing of many qubits, you need many quantum gates, and then you will not have a good quantum speed up in your calculation. Okay, so the purpose of this is to build the paper is they wanted to build C naught gate, quantum C naught gate. Okay, so any questions? If no, then I will proceed. In ions, they will use dipole transition forbidden states as their qubit states. But for theoretical, it is easier that we can control that we will see it as an effective dipole transition allowed state with very low spontaneous emission rate. Okay, because this is a toy model. So, in physically, if you have two dipole transition forbidden states and you want to drive some kind of transition, you will need the help of another state. And by coupling these two states, you can effectively build it into a effective electric dipole transition allowed state. Okay. This is a very famous technique called Raman transition. Okay. Raman transition. So in this paper, they will just postulate that the qubit have a very small spontaneous rate. Okay, so then we are going to start. The idea is that, well, these ions will like move like molecule, like some kind of molecule, okay? And what they want is that they cool down this ion stream into a so-called that they are almost look like a rigid body standing in the center of mass, okay? And what they do is they shine light on specific two qubits. So the information of the qubits will be transformed on the collective center of mass motion. Okay, so when I shine light, you can see that it is induced some kind of dipole, and the dipole will be pushed by light, and then it will like moving forward. Okay, and you know that there are other kinds of normal modes. Okay, but so they would may be like something like squeezing motion, like coming back and forth. But that frequency will be way higher than the laser light, so that normal mode will not be excited. So in the end, the ions are like a bunch of high mass thing that is moving along z direction. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the tedious part. This part is complicated. So what they do is that they first show that when you shine light on the first N ion, okay, and with some angle theta, and the ion, okay, I have to first write the internal states. These are the internal electron states of a qubit, okay? So they have this G state and E lin state and E1 state. The qubit is the information is stored in these two states, okay? But they need another state for they to do quantum computation. So the information has nothing to do with E1, okay? It is just for calculation. And they say that they can shine a laser light with a small detuning, okay? With a small detuning V, okay? It's V. Where V is the angular frequency of the simple harmonic motion of center of mass motion. Okay? So what will happen is they will perform this Hamiltonian. I will explain this if we have time. Okay? So this Hamiltonian. So these are just some constants. What they are going to say is that A and A dagger are the letter operators of the simple harmonic motion of the ion trap. Okay. So why they are doing when they shine a light on the N ion, it will drive a transition. Okay, and when it transition down, it will cause energy quanta will be left away from the ion trap anyway. Yes, it's not like that. So after performing this ion, this Hamiltonian, for some time they will be able to do this gate. They will open like, for example, it was a pi pulse or two pi pulse. That means effective Wabi oscillation or pi phase or two pi phase or something like that. Okay. So they have three steps. The first step is you give a pi pulse, okay? And the pi pulse will cause acting on the m qubit, okay? And what m qubit are going to do is that you will see that if it already is in ground state and the phonon is in vacuum state, then it will do nothing. Okay, so G and zero phonon state will not change. Okay. While so these two will not change. But these two they will go on transition. Okay, so E zero will go to G and the vacuum state will go to first quantum state, and they will be minus I quantum phase shift. Okay, so this is goes down like the same. Yeah, this is the phonon. Oh yeah. No. A and A dagger are phonon letter operators. Okay, A and A dagger are phonon operators. This Hamiltonian acts on the ion internal state and the ion external state and the light. Okay, but in this paper, the light is treated as classical light. Okay, so we don't care about the letter operators of light. We care about the phonon mode. Okay, that is most important. So, after this transition, it will go to like this. So, they shine a light that couples this state, that is first step, okay. The second step is that they shine the second light that couples these two states. But, okay, that is the second step. And what they do is, if you are in E0 state, it will do nothing. Okay, the second light is shine on the nth atom. Okay, so if the nth atom is on G, okay, and the phonon is on 1. G and 1, okay. Only in this case, they will give a minus 1 phase shift. Okay? So, why is that? Is that they couple these two states. So, it transition it and goes back. But since it's a 2 pi pulse, so it already gives a minus 1 phase. Okay? And later on, they perform another light on the original M. Switch them into the original state. So G goes back to G and the back part goes back to E. Okay. So what they do is that you can check that if the N ion is in G and the N ion is in plus state and minus state. Okay, and plus state and minus state are superposition of G and E. perform listening, then the Nth qubit will stay the same. But if you perform on this state, E state, it will perform a NOT. So what they do after this is that they shine another light on the Nth qubit and do single qubit rotation, and so the state are transformed back to G. Okay, so this is effectively a Sinar gate principle. So I want to recap that if you have these kind of Hamiltonians, okay, and that they drive these internal states, you can give a Sinar gate. That's what I want to say. Okay. Then the further problems are how do I build these Hamiltonians? And this state is just for helping on computation. Okay. So after a computation process, there will be no you have no probability on measuring E1. Okay. So they say you can by measuring E1, so you know that if anything is go wrong, so it's for error correction. Effectively, the N and the N qubits will be coupled together by this way. But you cannot direct couple them. So you first couple the N ion to the phonon state, and then couple the phonon state to the N ion. So in the end, you couple N and N ion. Right. So I want to do any arbitrary two qubit gates. I shine two lights on arbitrary qubits. Right. So any question? And then after one light to do single ion rotation, so actually L3. Okay?
So the phonon corresponds to the ion
lattice,
the collective motion of the ion
lattice? Yeah, the CM motion, simple harmonic motion. Yeah, so they say the simple harmonic normal mode is something like a information bus. The problem, I will say the problem of this scheme. There are some problems with this. If your state is in E and arbitrary and one phonon state, what will happen is that you will have some power to measure that you have G and second phonon state. Okay, so if something goes wrong, it will heat up, and it heats up, then information loss and the zero count computation. This is the main disadvantage of quantum computation, the main problem of this paper. Okay, so they want to, after a long time, after this scheme is proposed, they do this so-called Sirac-Toler gate in the experiment, but this doesn't work well. Okay. So the next important paper is that they found out that temperature is very annoying. So the next important theoretical proposal are called the Mohr-Solversen gate. They claim that they can do quantum computation in warm ions. Okay, so you don't need to cool down to absolutely 0 degrees, which is impossible. Okay. So this is the main disadvantage. And another disadvantage that you can see why gate time is low. Well, you need to transform state into the collective motion state. Okay. And it is very heavy, so it is like doing simple harmonic motion in a very slow pace. Okay, and if you don't want that, then you lose advantage of coupling qubit with motional states. So you can you always have that, and that cannot be accounted. You only that is why they say squid quantum computation are better than the armchair computation are in this. Like I said, if you, for example, every Rabi influence or the coupling between different N and N plus 1, are you thinking about creating N plus
I mean, like you say that there's another gate,
like Mohr-Solversen,
that can use more higher temperature.
Yeah.
So what was, I guess, why why was this necessary for local competition?
Okay, so if you have, what I want to say first is that in fundamental quantum mechanics, you think that we can create any state in any eigenstate, okay? But that is actually not physical in real world. That is very hard. In real world, when you are not so cold, you have a superposition across many Fock states, okay? And every Fock state coupled to each other with different coupling strength. So you will have a bad efficiency on doing quantum tuning on that. They so call that the quantum nature is lost because the simple harmonic nature becomes classical. And some problems will be like you will have many and many, many motional states entangled with your internal states. And effectively, this is some kind of decoherence. So this remains a very important topic in both experimental and theoretical armchair quantum computing. It's the main thing they want to overcome. Okay.
And so you're saying that the other trap can do this? Or?
The other so-called Bohmer-Sorensen gate. Okay. They say that if you are in a few Fock state superposition, which is still kind of physical, then you can do this so-called Bohmer-Sorensen gate. But they still have disadvantage. For example, when you are doing quantum computation, they may be heating. So heating will cause Bohmer-Sorensen gate to fail. But if you have a same temperature for a long time, then Bohmer-Sorensen gate is way better than Seebach solar gate. Okay, is there any questions? No. Any? Okay, if then I will proceed and I will erase this. Okay? So the next part is the more physical part. How do you build this Hamiltonian? And for how to build this Hamiltonian, it is they have two important papers published. I will give you the reference, but they are pretty tedious, so I won't go through them. I will just go by hand wave to show you that this is reasonable. Okay. And this is the first Hamiltonian that I have to build. There's another. That is the single qubit gate. I will tell you that in real time. So if this works well, you can couple your motional state with just one qubit. And they do this, but if you have an ion, okay, they shine light, which is in standing wave. Okay, why is in standing wave? So in standing wave, you have some potential that looks nice. This. Okay? Can you imagine that this is a standing wave of E field? Okay? You put some ion in this place. They claim that at this place, the light will cause the atom to encounter this kind of interaction. Okay? So the reason of that is that they assume two things. A, the spontaneous emission rate is very low. That is the nature of ion trap, and it is easy to think of that. So anyway, the spontaneous emission rate, they ignore that. That's the first one. The second one is that the ion, they will move around their, they will move around anyway. And the delta X is way smaller than lambda, which is the wavelength of light. Okay. So locally, like I said, the normal mode here will act like linear. Okay. Or something look like this. Okay. Is this part okay? Okay. So what is the Hamiltonian? Hamiltonian is E dot P, right? But E is proportional to x, right? Is that okay? So you have something like sigma are the Pauli matrix. Sigma are the Pauli matrix. Sigma are the Pauli matrix. Okay, sigma means lowering the state. So from Eling goes to G, and this is dagger, so G goes to Eling, E0. Okay, so this is responsible for, you can calculate this is proportional to the dipole of transition dipole of an ion. Okay, so this is just E dot P. And what is E0? When you have strong field, okay, I will write it in contents form. So this is effectively alpha plus alpha star. And alpha, the light is going through, okay, it will oscillate, okay? This is a field of a light. And you add it to this complex conjugate to get electric field, which is real, okay, can you understand? And what is x? X is the position of the ion. But in this scheme, the ion motion state are quantum mechanical. So I will, this is proportional to A plus A dagger. Okay, this is x. Okay, so far.
Can you explain P, momentum?
P.
Hello, P.
Oh, P. Okay. P is actually proportional to E dot state 1, okay, state 2. The location of your electron, right? So you are actually calculating this thing. And for G state, the average location of the electron coincides with its core, okay, so it's 0. If it is not 0, it is called permanent dipole. But in this case, it is 0. And in the end, you discover that during transition, this dipole moment is only related to the cross terms. Okay. The cross terms. So you say effectively, this operator is effectively the polymer. Okay, this is hand waving, but you can. This is all in Griffiths. Okay. No, okay. Anyway, if you want to ignore that, it has this mathematical form. Okay. So, what I want to do next is you expand this. You expand this. You have many terms, but in the end, you have. Alpha sigma dagger A dagger plus alpha star sigma A and plus other things. Yeah. Okay. And I will show that these are the only relevant part. Okay. Well, a more an important part is that the light that is shining on the atoms have a low, a small detuning. Then this minus mu, and mu is the angular frequency of the simple harmonic motion. So if you write it in interaction picture, quantum mechanics, okay, you do in interaction frame, you will find that some operators have time dependence, okay, and these have time dependence of exponential I omega of light. And this has exponential I omega of the internal angular frequency of state transition. Okay, and only when alpha and the four known angular momentum, angular frequency and the atom angular frequency are matched together, then the time dependent. These states are time dependent. These operators are time dependent. And then other terms are oscillating very fast. And if you do calculation, you will discover that fast oscillating operators in interaction picture doesn't contribute. So this is so-called RWA approximation. And this is actually just this term. Okay? You can see that alpha is a complex, so it has an exponential phase. And A are the net operators of owner. And sigma here, sigma dagger here. Okay? So I build this. And what if I need to do a single atom qubit gate? I don't want the motional state to couple to the line. So I put the ions in the node of the standing wave, okay, here. And in the standing wave here, if you do first order approximation, there is no electric field difference across this small x, right? So the Hamiltonian doesn't depend on x. That is, you does not couple the phonon field to light or atom. So you only change the internal state of an atom. Okay? So the Hamiltonian will look something like this. We expand that doing RWA approximation, and these are the most valuable parts. And you also will see that you don't want any detuning of the light and your frequency of your atom, your ion. And that is how they design their single ion qubit gate. Okay. So in principle, you can do. Then you can have universal quantum computation. Okay, so bye bye.
One
time only one gate, because you have you can only have a specific Hamiltonian at some time, and then after some time you change the Hamiltonian, which is changing the gate. So every time you can only perform a gate.
But
a gate.
One gate.
Or you can simultaneously doing other quantum computation.
Yeah.
For example, you shine two light on this, and you shine two light on this. But if they all required to share the center of mass no more, this will break. So if you have other kind of gates, they only have to be single qubit gates. Okay. But still, if you have center of mode moving, okay, the other single ion qubit gate will be hard to perform because your light have to coincide with your atom, with your ion. So the best way to do is you perform a gate. Or your fidelity will be very low. Okay.
But if you can use control a lot of qubit, how can you do quantum?
You can perform only one gate at a time, but after a long time you can perform many gates. So if your gate time is short, okay, then you can do many steps. Okay. It's somehow different. In quantum computing, you can say that every ions are entangled with each other. So if you do something with some ion, everybody's affected. Okay, this is very different from traditional computing. And it is why now we only have like 15 qubits. Okay.
So what's the limitation now?
The limitation now, some part are from technology, and your light, the laser is not good enough. There are, for example, many kind of errors. If you want to do readout, in our implementation, you will want your atom on some kind of local, okay? So this will be locally to be face have to be very, you have very good timing on your face, and these are very hard. Okay. Another kind of things are that if your electrodes are not good enough, it will vibrate your ion stream and it will cause anomalous heating. Okay. And your ions will go away. And this won't work. And you have magnetic field. Magnetic field will change the spectra of your ion. And that will cause error. Okay. You have many kind of vibration are also you need motional state, so you don't want vibration. Okay. So first, it is already hard in laboratory to do good quantum computation. Okay. While you have other physical disadvantage and the technology disadvantage. Okay. If you have better laser light, it will be better. But that is good company to do that. So we can just wait for like 20 or 30 years. There are many companies. They sell good lasers. They sell good single photon source. Then you have a better shot on doing more qubit computation.
But you believe that this is a good way to achieve quantum computation?
The Dirac tolerogate is not a good way. But the idea of putting information on the bus is unique and special. And I cannot think of another way to do this kind of universe. Okay. Oh.
你说现在可以做的事情，它之所以是 scalable 的原因，是因为你可以在一串 ion 里面任意选 两个 来做 two qubit gate。然后这个 two qubit gate 在作用的时候，你怎么确定它跟其他的没有，比如说交互作用或？
You may have not some like they already rule out like Coulomb interaction, okay? Because like I said, you may have other kind of normal that be excitable. So if you couple your state to that kind of motion, then you will start finding that your ions are not moving like in a rigid body. They will be like squeezing or torching, and that is bad. But the frequency of other normal modes are way higher than your laser form, your laser frequency. So you won't excite them in principle. Okay. So that is one physical way to for that you can do better quantum. But there are other kind of force, for example dipole force or quadruple force. Okay. And so somebody are doing research on that like in Juda. Okay.
Actually I'm quite confused about the whole picture because I lost at the very beginning. So I mean the purpose of this paper is that you want to construct a CNAP gate, right?
Yep.
It means that I'll use that kind of potential, rotating, and I can trap a bundle of ions.
Yeah.
And then I can randomly pick two ions and use the CNAP gate to read the information or computation.
Computation. I haven't said how to do readout, but readout is very easy. Okay. But the hard part is computation. They only cover how to do CNAPGate, and CNAPGate is just for computation.
Okay. And the way to construct CNAPGate is use that Hamiltonian you write on the back.
Yeah, and the physical picture is by coupling your internal state with the motion of the moving ions. Okay. You already need to remember that the Hamiltonians are actually not so important.
And the last part of your speech is you are telling us how to create the Hamiltonian.
Yeah, the physical part. This is more like atomic physics. So very easy atomic physics. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Other questions? They have some simulations. Can you check? Barium. They use barium. Ba. Ba. Barium. Okay, they use barium.
What kind of In classical computer or simulation quantum computation in classical computer or
which is stupid, but you need to do simulation before you build the computer.
That's what result.
Okay, so they did a simulation on the so-called quantum Fourier transform. You can Google this. And why it is important, I cannot tell you because it's no medical and there's a lot of details in it. But that is the many good algorithms that have good quantum speed ups are related to quantum Fourier transform.
So you can do quantum Fourier transform in zero.
Yeah, and anyway, you have to read out your state in quantum Fourier transform algorithm. So in principle, you have like perfect peaks, and you from reading the peaks, you know your answer. You are actually read out your computation result. So if you have incoherence or other error, the peaks will be broken. And they calculate this and they say the peaks are still there, so you can do quantum computation, although in realistic.
But we can do this now.
We can do quantum Fourier quantum Fourier transformation in just a few qubits.
Okay.
So like 4 qubits.
Okay.
If you have 4 qubits, you have calculated up to factory up to 2 to the power 4, which is 16. So they show that 15 is 3 multiplied by 5. And then this is already very hard.
So we can do this right now with this.
With four ions. This is actually happened like 10 years ago. And now we can do better. I think they have only already achieved like 5,000, a factoring of 5,000 number, around 5,000. And but we of course with other kind of algorithms, physical implementation. I mean, yep.
对，你 use 的 green chalk。